طلعت وتحت ولا فوق؟ name of the father the son the holy spirit one god amen. By the grace of God, I am very, very embarrassed. Very, very embarrassed. Why? I'm telling you why. I always come here to the church. It's always, I don't know how many years now, more than 15 years, I come to the church. I learn from here. Truly, I'm speaking. Truly. I always come to this meeting when I'm here to learn. I never expect to stand here and to have the privilege and to stand here where great, great fathers, great teachers stood here before. It's a great honor for me. And the church, I preach because it is my work. In the church, where we go to church, we pray liturgy, we contemplate in the word of God, I find it easy truly to speak. But today, it is very difficult for me to stand here. I'm sure the old people who attended this meeting before knows the feeling, knows what I am talking about. I'm saying again, it's a great honor to stand here in this place, in this pulpit, to address the meeting, Light and Life. I told Abuna yesterday, there is a verse I was busy with it from 2 Corinthians chapter 4. Yani we are ending the year. And this verse, I don't know if I will finish the topic or not, but let me begin. When the time come, just let me to stop. Because I don't know when, I wrote a lot of stuff here. I don't know if it will finish or not. But let us go by the grace of God, and the Spirit of God will lead us, and the message reach every heart. We need the message to reach every heart. And if it reach your heart, it will take your mind. If the message came to your heart, really, you will follow it. The message, it says, therefore, we do not lose heart, even though our outer man is perishing, yet the inward man is being renewed day by day. If I ask you, do you know this verse? Sure, you read this verse before, right? You have read it before? Can we read it again? Can we all of us read it?
Therefore, we do not lose heart, even though our outward man is perishing, yet the inward man is being renewed day by day.
Let us take this verse and we divide it part by part. He said here to us, do not lose heart. Why? Why St. Paul asking this? Do not lose heart. While we have here a loss, perishing, he said here, the outer man is, I want you to repeat after me so you can think about the verse. The outer man is how? How is the outer man perish? Simple. Huh? Dying. Huh? sickness. What else? Dying. This is the most physical, important fact. Generation to generation. We are this generation. Next generation is coming, and after generation is coming generation until the coming of Christ. So he said here, the outer man is perishing. This is the law of the flesh. This is the law of the flesh. Are you aware about that? Are you aware that the flesh one day will lay him down in 6 by 4? A small hole. I don't know, we have holes here, what you have here in America. In Africa, we dig a hole. 6 feet by 4 feet. That's all. This is the end of the flesh. It will end down in the ground. And the outer man, listen to that, has had the ruhim kuzul wadda. The outer man has beginning and has end. Date of birth, and after long time, they will write in a small, whatever, small board or a small, whatever you say it, the date of what? The date of this. Did you think about it? Did you think about it? One day your name will be written. He's born in such a day and he died in such a day. Did this come to your mind? Hello. This idea came to your mind that one day your name will be written like that? If it is not, please think about it. This is the outer man, fixed by date of birth and by date of death or dead. But what about the inward man, the inner man? What do you think? When is the beginning and when is the end? From your experience, from your spiritual experience, when is the inner man start? And baptism? Start in the day of baptism. We get the inner man. The ending? Ending when? This group say no. What about here? Is the inner man end? Sure? Why you are sure? Give me evidence. Abuna said, the spirit doesn't die. Okay. So it means the spirit will live forever, right? We agree about that. The spirit, as my sister mentioned here, we get the new man the day of baptism. We get born. Never die. Why? Why the spirit doesn't die? This is very good information. We have been made on the image of God, and He's eternal. Very good. We took it in baptism, right? Right? What else? You said he's eternal. Good. How we get this privilege? We said baptism, there's something else. We got this nature from the baptism. We got the image of Christ. What else? There's something missing. We should know it. What else? The missing small things. What happened to Jesus on the cross? He died, and on the third day, he resurrected. So we got this spirit. We should understand. We got the spirit of resurrection. Not only we get his image and enough and in the baptism, no. We got the power of resurrection. Is that correct? Correct? Hello? Yes. Please interact with me, otherwise I will leave you and I escape. So, the new man born in the day of baptism, and they receive the power of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. We take this power in Christ, through the Holy Spirit. We became what? We became his image. We look like him. The question, number one, do we look like him now? Do we look like Christ in our daily activities? No, not if you want. Do we look like him? Maybe, yes, maybe no. Do we look like Christ? Sometimes. And sometimes no. So we became what? How we look like? What is the name Jesus rebuked? He rebuked someone like that. Yes. Pharisees. Hypocrisy. Hypocrite. Imagine we are hypocrite. We are hypocrite. Why you are hypocrite? While we talk the image of Christ. We take his image. We receive his power. We are like him. But we don't do the work like him. We don't act like him. We don't live like him. Maybe this word which I will give you, it can depress you, but this is the fact. This is the reality. It's good. We are in the end of the year. We're ending the year. I should look how much I give to my inner life. How much I give to my inner man. How much my inner man is feeded every day. I feed him every day. You feed yourself every day, right? How many times? How many times we eat a day? Some people say because the diet, because of I want to be slim and handsome and beautiful, because I have some little clothes brand new and I need to use it so I lose weight, or I'm getting married, I want to lose weight. No, this is not the issue. We eat every day to do what? So we can live, so we can survive. But what about the inner man? Need to eat or not? Is the inner man need food or not? We know, right? But we don't do. We know. That's why the one who loves Christ, the one who really loves the Lord, and has literally God in his heart, leading his life, he cares about the inner, not the outer. He cares about his feelings. He cares about his virtue. He cares about these inner things, which to tell I am spiritual or I am carnal. Is this is in our mind and our agenda when I wake up? I want to feed the inner before I feed the outer. Or during the day we have agenda. Today I want to sit to feed my spirit, to feed my inner. Do we have that? Please, if you don't have that, consider that your inner man crying from hunger. He is hungry. He is very hungry. We are very good in organizing our daily schedule. We are very good, no one to cross our boundary in our daily schedule. Can I visit you? No, 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 I am busy. Come next week. What time, what time? From 5 to 5:15. Why? Because 5:16, I have lunch, or I have second supper, or I have whatever. Yes, we are very precise and specified in our daily agenda. But what about our inner agenda? Please, this is the time to recalculate your schedule. Your inner man need to eat. Your inner person need to grow. Correct? Are you the same 10 years ago? 5 years ago? 1 year ago? I don't know. You know yourself. But if, my friend, if we take care only for the outer, what is the result? What is the result? Huh? If I take care, how normally people take care, as I said? They grow, they eat well, they go to gym, they choose what to eat, what they not to eat. Some people massage the body. Yes. Some people, yes, you are laughing. Yes. Some people go to extra activity to build the muscles, to build whatever. And at the end, you find him losing power, losing focus, losing ability. If someone only focus on that, the end of the day you find him running mad. He was putting all his effort in the outer, which some of us do that. Some of us look at the beauty of the outer and neglecting the beauty of the inner, which is very, very important. Outer will what? What will happen to the outer? This fact we should know. We should keep this verse in front of us, in the fridge, in the kitchen, in the toilet, in the bedroom. Yes, leave this verse. Leave it. Keep it. Keep this verse in front of your eyes, in the top of your ceiling when you sleep. When you sleep, put your head up and see, look, oh, the outer will perish. Yes. Imagine if every day you do that. Anyone put his hope in the outer only, he will run mad, right? He will run crazy. That's why we should keep this in front of us every day. What about the inner person? What about the inner? I ask the people today question in the gospel, in the liturgy. And I answered. I said, if someone asks you, how are you doing? What is the answer? What is the answer? Fine. This fine is very polite, by the way. Very good. Other ones say, huh? Busy. Oh, I'm pushing the days. We are trying, Abuna. Days are difficult, full of problems. I pray that this day finish without disaster. Yes. I pray this day that my wife or my husband does not do the funny things they do every day. I pray, I pray. But no one said, this is our language. Really, this is our attitude. No. No. How are you? I am. I say today, I am. I am blessed. I am blessed. How are you? I'm alive with the grace of God. How are you? I am blessed because God in my life. How are you? I am growing in the spirit. Thank God. This is the answer. This should be the answer for the people who care for the inner, not the outer. So the language, it can tell if you are spiritual or not spiritual. It can tell the answer, the way you answer. It can tell you are a man of God or not. The inner should be what? Renewed day by day. Nothing cold, old. If you imagine the sun which come every day, how many times you have seen the sun in your life? Give me any years. But don't say the true, yani. Don't say the good now. 25 years. Abuna. Not. You 10 years. Only 10 years. So we see the sun every day. Every day we see the sun. How many of you went to the ocean? All of us went to the ocean every day. Is the ocean is the same? Can I say the ocean is old? Or the sun now it is old enough? No, every day is what? Renew. Every day new. I can't say this is old. I can't. What about our inner life? Renewed daily? Or not? Renewed or not? Don't say, oh, days like the same, yesterday, like today, like tomorrow. No, my friend. No. No. We should grow in what? St. Paul say what? Grow in what? Grow in knowledge. Grow in faith. Grow in virtue. Grow in love, grow in speech, right? Grow. Are we growing? We should grow in all these things until we reach where? Who can tell me? Until we reach where? To the image of the head. Yeah. Until we reach to the head. Until we go to heaven. Until we reach to the head, Christ. You see the ability we have? We grow, we grow, we grow, we grow until we reach to Christ the head. Yeah. It can work. Oh, it can work. If we allow the Spirit to work, if we allow Him to work, He will make me to grow. But if you care for the outer, good luck for you. All the best. You'll run mad. The spiritual life is the inner man growing day after day. We agree about this verse. The spiritual man grow day after day. Grow in the grace of God every day. Grow in the knowledge of God every day. A child today is in the crib. After 1 week or after 1 month will be born the same? No. What will happen to the baby? Will grow. Will grow. And when or he or she grow, Abuna or the leaders can identify and say, this daughter belong to this mama, right? This boy belong to this dad. How we know? How we know? He look like, right? the image look like? We also should look like Christ. We take his image, my friend. We are like him. We take his image. Do you agree? Yes, right? We agree, we take his image. We take his image. When I stand and I pray to the Lord, I say, Lord, before I don't have heart of forgiveness, but now I love my family. I forgive them. Before, I was not loving my colleague, but now I start, Lord. Means what? Growing. You are standing at the gate. You are standing at the gate of knowledge of God. Before, my life was terrible, was bad, but through the grace of God, through coming to fellowship in the church, fellowship with the Bible, I am start to know my weakness, and I admit myself to God, and God give me forgiveness. This someone is someone is what? Growing. Before, Lord, I don't used to believe in you, in many things, but now I am, by the grace of God, I start to know. I start to build my faith. It is little by little. Little by little. The inner will will grow. Will grow. Until we reach where? The perfection in heaven. Until we reach Christ. There is a law in the, I don't know, it is in the chemistry or in the physics or chemistry, I think. No, biology, sorry. You know this, what you call it, the genes, the children take the genes of the father and the mother, right? We take the genes of Christ. In baptism, we take his gene. We take what from him? We take what? We take his power. We take his resurrection. We take his holiness. We take it. We look like him. But the problem, we damage that. The problem, we damage that in our daily activities. We take victory in his resurrection, right? Every time Abuna in resurrection time, we take his victory. What victory? To overcome what? Evil. To overcome evil, the sin, the death of sin. We have this ability. You see how much we lost if we don't grow from inside? You see how much? I was reading the story of Abu Ma'ar. Abu Ma'ar, you know Abu Ma'ar, Saint Macarius? One day, he came to his cell. What do you think you'll find in his cell? What do you think? What do you find in his room? Small room, what do you find? Imagine, what can we find there? What, laptop? iPad? What do you find, please, for the time? Bible, Psalmody, Agbaya. That's all. One day he came, he found thieves enter, stealing the small stuff he has in his room. So they get embarrassed, they run away. So he enters to the room, he find, I don't know what, a small cup or whatever. He ran after them. Hey, my friend, you forgot this. You forgot to take this. Is this man from the earth? Is this person from the earth? Such a behavior, such attitude. He ran after the thieves to tell them, you forgot to take this stuff. How you look at the thieves? How you judge them? How you look at the thieves who steal and murder and kill and whatever? How you judge them? How you look at them? I need an answer, please. Bad. It's very polite. You always choose the polite word. Thank you. Thank you very much. How we look at them, please? Bad, only bad? Sick? This is very polite also. I can't find a word to identify them. I wish if I catch them and I do what? Revenge. And I do what? Cut them to pieces. Yes. This is the way we look. This is the outer man, not the inner. Look at Saint Macarius, what he did. Forgiveness. How we look at the thieves. Then another one went to the market to sell his basket. After he sold the baskets, one monk, he remained with some money. Listen to that. He went to the shop to buy a heavy clothes for him for the winter. And he folded it, and he bought it in a chair, and he sat on it. And he was talking to someone. Someone came from behind to pull it from him. What imagine this man did? He pretend that he's standing. So the other man can do what? Yeah. What is that? What these people live in our time? They live on the earth with us? Yes. How you look at someone, take your right. How you look at him? How you deal with someone steal from you? If you revenge, means you are taking care of the outer. I know it is very high, but it need to consider that. We need to let the inner to grow. If the inner grow, let them to take. Yeah, welcome, take. Because I know the outer will go where? One day I was in the monastery, long time, in the 70s, and I attended a new monk coming, new brothers coming to the monastery. So the abbot introduced the brother to the monk. I was there, I was like 11 years or 10 years. I saw it by myself. So the guy, the abuna introduced the brother to the monks, say, this is brother so and so, he will be with us. So he called the brother, he say, please. He was agreeing with him before we meet. He come with us to the grave. Let us go to the grave of the monastery. So he went and he called the one of the farmers to give him this shovel or something to dig on the ground. Anyway, he digged. He digged a small hole like this depth of my feet, my hand. I say, you digged? He say, yes, Abuna, I digged. So tell him, give me your certificate. Give me your certificate. So he opened the bag. Egypt at this time was in a war. It just came up from war. So anyone to have a degree at this time, very rare. This man was having like, I think, 3 or 4 degrees, doctorates. And he framed his certificate. It was very nice. He took them and say, put them here. Say, yes, Abuna. He bought the certificate and he buried them. And he said to him, you are a doctor so-and-so? I say, no, I'm no more. I'm no more doctor. I'm no more this person who learned all these studies. No more. So Abuna was trying to do what? To kill the outer. To kill what he has from possessions or from a wealthy life or from whatever. And I have learned the lesson. Until now, I can see these pictures every day. He taught him a lesson. To start growing with the inner man. I will not speak too much. I engage you today with this verse. There is still a lot to go. There is still a lot to know about Christ. Right? Is that right or no? Still a lot of time waiting for us to know about our Lord. Please, take this time while we're ending the year to grow more from inside and enough taking care of the outer. Enough. You lived on earth, I don't know how many years, 20, 50, 60, we care only for the outers. Please, today we need to look and to see where is our faith, where is our eternal life be, where is our knowledge about God, where is all these things which is God put it in us. God put it in us. We need to care for that. We need to look at our virtues. Virtues is there, means the inner is growing. If there is no virtue in my life, means the outer is growing and the inner remaining the same. Okay? We agree? From today, we see, can we read it last time? And we end here. Amen. Glory be to God forever and ever.